Danny Reid, you bring the day to an end with the singles matches, and in absolutely scintillating style, people are sitting next to me and they're thoroughly enjoying the performance. 4-2 against Hunor, but not the best of starts. You lose the first game, then come back to win the first two. Now, what were the problems early in the match?
I just felt it took me time to get used to his game. He had quite a good serve, and maybe I was going for the wrong receive, and maybe it took a while to settle down because I had a bit of a close round this morning. So I just slowly played myself in, really, and got more and more confident as the match went on.
Well, just looking at the next two games, if I look at the fourth and fifth game, I think you lose the fourth 13-11, but then you win the fifth 14-12. Now, how crucial was that fifth game?
That was massive, yeah. He was starting to make a lot of good shots, to be honest, and coming back into the match. So at that time, I was 10-7 down in the fifth, and he was slowly coming back. And I think that's something I've improved on. My head's a lot stronger. I'm a lot able to just play under pressure and keep playing my game and keep a high level. And I think that's why I'm winning these matches.
Well, I mean, congratulations, fine performance, but many players will tell me you win a close game and then you go from strength to strength. Now, winning that close fifth game, how much did that actually help you in the sixth?
It's just given me more confidence. Last week in the Commonwealth Championships, I had a lot of close games that I won, so I just feel like more comfortable in those situations now. I'm a lot more calm as a person, and I've developed in a good way, I think.
Now, if I look back some 6 years, 2007 in Zagreb, it seemed to be the tournament that Danny Reid made his breakthrough. Good wins in the group, and a certain Trinco Kane. You gave him a right test in the first round of the men's singles event. Now, what sticks in your mind from Zagreb 2007?
To be fair, some of the good stuff I'm doing now is from then, but I was a young player who just sort of went for it with no fear, and I think now I'm a mature senior who's starting to build an all-round game with different game plans and sort of able to adapt when people figure out my game. I think at that time I just sort of went for my one way and just went for it 100% without a lot of psychology, whereas now I think I'm a more mature senior, really.
It seemed to work okay then, but you've mentioned your head's maybe better, more mature. Could you highlight anything technically that has improved since Zagreb 2007?
Over the last summer, I changed my forehand technique, and I think I'm winning a lot more points with my forehand. I'm getting a lot more quality. My serve, everything's more quality on it, really. That's what I'm trying to do. And yeah, I'm just happier as a player. I'm enjoying it a lot more.
Could you highlight anything in the match against Hunor? I think maybe forehand topspin or backhand topspin down the parallel proved very successful.
My half-long straight with my forehand, and when I was down in that fifth game, my backhand flick was what sort of parallel won me the match, really. So it's nice to trust my strengths in those situations and win those matches.
Good technique, a cool head, focus, concentration. It works for Danny Reid through to the men's singles event here at the LIEBHERR World Championships in far off Paris.